Well, Coach, I'll get started here. What does it mean for you personally, finally, to be in game week after all of this?
The answer really is that it has nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with these 29 guys that have been working really since the end of last season. This is the message every day, is that it's the team over the individual, and I'm just a part of the team here. I understand that the chair I sit in, I might have to be on Zoom calls more than all the guys in the team and maybe make some lineup decisions, but really this is a testament to the hard work they've done. This is showing that we can do and solve problems together, that if we remain resilient in our plan and believe in our process that we've done since the end of last season, all the way through all the challenges of COVID throughout the summer and the uncertainty of a season, and then, you know, small area practices and groups of nine and then groups of 15. So I'm not even trying to be a smart aleck there. It doesn't really have much to do with me. This is a time for celebration for the 29 guys that are lucky enough to play for us.
Coach, a couple of weeks ago, I actually talked with you and you said, you know, when you guys first knew that you wouldn't be playing right away, and you said each weekend was going to be treated like a game week. What's your record right now?
Well, I'm undefeated. I mean, that's the best part. And you know, I know the joke's already been said, but we made the playoffs. So I think we can just kind of relax right now. And that might be the message for the guys on Saturday. And even this week, we've kept reminding all the players, like, this is fun. Like, this is a fun game. We're so lucky to be able to do it. We're so lucky to have the opportunity to play and to do what we love. I'm so fortunate. I don't even have a job. This isn't a job. I don't work. This is outstanding for me to be sitting next to all the guys I sit next to every day and be in front of a group of young men that have shown us what it takes to be a team, us as a coaching staff. So the weekends, we've treated them like game weekends. We did have a small pause in with some COVID stuff, but the way that the young men reacted and were so amenable to different ways of learning. We did a lot of stuff via Zoom, and it wasn't just hockey stuff. It was learning about each other. We did projects where each person on the team was able to tell their own story and talk about the people that were important to themselves and how they got here and why they play hockey. And then we tricked them one night and told them they had a big hockey project, and then we asked all their parents to send in photos of them when they were young men, and we asked them specifically to make sure that the photos were, I think the word was, cringeworthy. So we had a lot of fun with that one, trying to see which player was which player. So we've had some fun, and then as we got closer to the day coming up on Saturday, we've done up our work boots and got the focus going for UMass.
Coach, you guys knew that when everything was put on pause, that this was the weekend that you guys were going to be allowed to start playing games again. You didn't have a game on the schedule for this weekend. So what was the process like in terms of kind of figuring out, okay, not only are we going to be playing this weekend, we don't know who we're playing, and then all of a sudden, okay, yeah, we're playing one of the best teams in the country in UMass.
Well, Jack, we have to start with us first. And that's going to be this whole season, and probably for as long as I'm lucky enough to be here. It's about us. It's about what we control. It's about how we play. And we don't want to be reactionary to how other teams play. We want to dictate it. And how you dictate it is by having a structure and a system in place and then having the players take ownership of that. So, you know, would I rather play the University of Hawaii? Absolutely. Like, that would, and I wouldn't mind playing in Maui right now. That would be outstanding, but it is what it is. And we're playing UMass, who is one of the best teams in college hockey and coached by an outstanding coach and Greg Carvel. But at the end of the day, it's all of the jerseys that we have on and the young men that are on the bench in front of us as coaches. So it really is about us, and which is the title of the project we did at the team was about us. And it actually was, the whole narrative was towards this message that we are the ones who can solve these problems. And your poise as a player will be revealed, and your ability to do things and your ability to understand what we're asking you to do as a player will be revealed pretty shortly. We don't have the luxury of an exhibition season. We can't play the University of Hawaii. We've tried. They don't want to come here for some reason. And now it's just about really the guys sit with the guys next to them and figuring out how to solve these problems. And then at the end of the day, we just open the door for them as coaches, and they got to go out there and perform.
Coming off of playing off that answer there, Coach, from all of the workouts that you guys have had and all the practices and the scrimmages even, what are you most curious to see about your team when they take the ice this weekend?
I think the first couple minutes is going to be an interesting one. Like the nerves, we want to shake those out right off the bat because we haven't had opponents to play. We haven't been able to play some of the Canadian universities like we would normally do and just get the feel for each other and even different positions and different line mates. Myself, I'm really excited to see who's going to take the leadership roles inside these games when things don't go our way, because hockey, it really is a game of momentum swings. A season is momentum swings. A career is momentum swings. So we're looking for those players that have that poise. We want to make sure that our leaders understand that leadership is a skill. Like, leadership is something that it's not a rank. It doesn't, just because Andrew Lucas has a C on his jersey doesn't mean that he's ranked differently than the guys he plays with. It's something that you show when the times are tough. So that's what I'm most excited to see, is the small details we've been teaching them hockey-wise and systems. Absolutely. We had a scrimmage last night, and it was so fun for the coaches to see the details we've asked to come out through the game that we did last night. And then now we want these guys to get out there, have fun, work, play hard for each other, and reveal themselves to their teammates and to the coaches, and then ultimately to all the people who support the team.
Obviously, the postponement was disappointing to the guys, an extra month of having to wait to play. What were some of the advantages of these extra 4 or 5 weeks to get some skills and whatnot under their belt?
Well, Andrew, I think that the extra month that we had allowed us to work on the habits and details that we're trying to get out of these players. Every one of these players wants to be a professional player when they leave UVM. And if you're going to do that, you have to have certain habits. Working hard, it's not enough. Like, that's the absolute bare minimum if you want to play in the NHL. Like, you're not special if you work hard. That's the benchmark for what everybody has to do. So we want our players to know that they have to carry that hard work and that they have to show that we are a team comprised of individuals who will be trying to constantly improve. So that extra month that you talked about, that extra month was 4.5 weeks to be able to work on those habits and details. And, you know, when you're a young child and you're just learning how to walk, or you're learning how to brush your teeth or comb your hair, or obviously I don't do that, but, you know, when you do these things, like, they're habitual. You have to do them all the time and all the time and all the time. So all those extra practice hours, we believe, have led us to have a little bit more confidence going into this season.
Coach, with that in mind, does it make it tough knowing that you're playing against a team that does have some games under their belt already? Or do you feel like being fresher is an advantage going into these games?
I mean, there's two ways, exactly like you said there, Jack. Like, there's two ways to look at that. So, I mean, we're going to choose to look at it like we're fresher, you know, like we're not too concerned about the opponents that we're playing. We're more concerned about how we play, because that's what we can control. We can dictate how they play with our effort and with our compete. Any mistakes in the world can be forgiven, let's say, by the coaching staff and your teammates if you work through them and you work hard. And then if you do make a mistake and you get back out, you try not to make that mistake again. And then you do things like take a cross check the back for your teammates or block a shot for your teammates, which has been the foundation of this team since, you know, way back when this team started, all the way from Coach Cross, all the way through everybody here. That's a hallmark of this team, and we're going to continue that tradition.
Anything else for Coach, guys?
All right. Well, I hope everybody has a nice and safe and happy holiday season. We're going to put on Andrew Lucas for you here, and he's going to be a lot more articulate than I am, that's for sure. So
please, thanks, Coach.
Everybody,
thanks, Coach. See you this weekend.
Okay, soon. Okay, thank you. Don't say anything bad about me, okay? I can see this later on.
Yeah.
You want to be on the power play every night.
How's it going?
Good, Andrew. Good. How about you?
I'm good, thanks.
Well, I'll ask you the first same question I asked Coach. What does it mean for you? What does it mean for your teammates to finally be in game week?
Oh, it's just awesome. We've all been waiting to play a game for 9 months now, and it's just, it feels good to be getting ready for something that means something.
I talked to Coach when you guys first were told that you're going to have to, you know, the whole all the winter sports be paused for a while. You guys missed about a month plus or so, whatever it was. But he said you guys are still treating every weekend like a game week. What was that like?
Yeah, that was good. I mean, it's just good to get ready with your preparation week to week, get ready for – we've been doing scrimmages every Saturday, so we're treating each week like a game week, and it's good just practice, and it's fun to compete against your team, even if it is just a scrimmage.
One of the things I just asked Coach was, you guys are going into a situation where this is going to be your first game of the year. It's not going to be your opponent's first game of the year. Do you feel like that's an advantage or a disadvantage or somewhere in between?
Like you said, there's two ways to look at it. I mean, it's a new coaching staff, new systems for all the guys. So it was good to just get the details down and work on the systems every day with our coaches.
From a player standpoint, what has been the thing about the kind of the message and the mindset that Coach Woodcroft and his staff have brought here that has been most exciting to you guys?
Really just focus on the details, from your stick detail to your skate detail. Every time you're on the ice, there's so many little things you have to work on and focus on. So it's just been great working with the new coaching staff on the little things.
As a leader of this team, obviously it's your job to keep the guys in line and keep everybody together, especially during this COVID time. Everybody wants to be careful and make sure they're staying safe. How has that been for you as a sophomore trying to keep the upperclassmen accountable?
Well, our team's been great. Everyone's been doing the right thing. Everyone wants to play, so it hasn't been too hard to make sure guys are doing the right thing or not going out or anything like that. Everyone has the same goal in mind, which is to play games and to win games ultimately.
You know, obviously I mentioned that you guys have kind of been playing these game weeks every week, but you know, what's it going to be like, you think, Friday night, trying to get to sleep knowing that you're playing an actual opponent, you know, 24 hours later or so?
Well, it's like the night before Christmas. No one can ever sleep, but we're excited. You know, it's been, like I said, 9 months since we played, and it's going to be a fun one. UMass is a good team, and we're excited to play them first night.
Does that make it tough? Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Does it make it tough knowing that you're jumping in here? You guys haven't played in 9 months, and obviously you worry about the things that you can control, but this is one of the best teams in the country that you're seeing in your first game action in however long.
Well, yeah, no team in Hockey East is an easy weekend, so it didn't really matter to us who we were playing. We wanted to be ready ourselves.
I mean, you know, athletes, you know, so much about, you know, what athletes do is based on routine. And during a routine year, you'd have a schedule. You could look at it and say, all right, this weekend we're playing these guys, and this week we're playing these guys. And this is a perfect example of how this season's not going to be that way. You weren't scheduled to play anybody this weekend. And then on Tuesday, it's announced that you're playing UMass. So how do you kind of prepare yourself, both personally and as a team, for the fact that more likely than not, you know, the schedule at the end of this is going to look a lot different than what it looks like right now?
Well, I think every team tries to focus on just the games coming up. So with the uncertain schedule this year, it's almost easier where you don't know who you're going to be playing in 2 weeks. You just can only focus on the team you're playing that upcoming weekend. So right now all we're focused on is UMass, and then after that, whatever happens, happens.